Hello folks and welcome back to the channel. I got another tutorial video for you guys, but before we get into this, let's get this YouTube stuff out of the way. If you like following content, make sure to hit that like button and then share it on your social media. When you share it on your social media, follow me on that Orange Man Bad app. The link is in the description. Subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell for all if you haven't done it yet already. And leave some comments underneath the video if you have any questions, comments, whatever. Just leave them down there and I'll get back to you guys. Those are all the free and easy things you can do to help support the channel. If you want to support the channel directly, look down in the description. Use that Ko-fi link to do a one-time tip or to join as a monthly channel member. All right, guys, let's get into this. Roll that intro. Okay guys, so we are back in our cell, and in this video we are going to do the external nav mesh editing. However, before that, if you go back and you watch this series, way back at the beginning I said that when I made the locations for our exterior and interior, our parent location for the interior is a farm exterior. And that's got all the location reference types in it, correct? Right. But I had said we put in the parent location for the Fall Creek Hold, which this is in. And I said later on, we're gonna select the world reference marker. So go ahead, open up your exterior location if you have one, and double click this. Now, the best exterior location reference, you can pick, let's go ahead and cancel this out because I need to zoom out a little bit. You can pick like this X marker if you want to, I think. Let's go ahead and look at this. Yeah, you can pick this X marker or you can pick the map marker. I use the map marker. And you can see where it comes up in the ref type right here. It'll say reference, map marker, blah, blah, blah. That's our map marker. So we're going to go ahead and pick that. And world location radius, don't worry about that. So that's okay. And right now, save your mod. Because it is important. All right, guys, now we're going to actually move into the nav meshing. This is an important thing to do when you're doing an exterior nav meshing. Now, there are a couple of processes for it that some people recommend. First, you have to turn on your nav mesh. So go ahead and click on your nav mesh mode here, or control E, and when that turns on, you'll see this bar come up. I usually just slide it around a little bit, and you'll see that the nav mesh is sorta is there, but you'll see it goes under the stairs, it goes there. When you go around to the side, oh, see, sometimes that happens. So you can see where it comes like to the side of the house or whatever. If you want to cure that from happening, just select one of the nav mesh things and the camera will rotate around it. Now you'll see where the nav mesh goes underneath the house. And if you turn on your see-through mode, which is the view mode, which is on top, the second button here, you'll be able to see where the
nav mesh is underneath the house. There, that's what you want to take out. So, and like I said, there's a couple of, different ways people will tell you how to do it. The first one is to move the nav mesh underneath the ground so far that the NPCs can't find it. That's a problem, however, because when you're nav meshing like the stairs and up here, that nav mesh is still underneath of it, and you can't nav mesh over top of nav mesh when there's active nav mesh underneath it. You have to get right down to the floor and everything. You don't really need to do that. The second way is to make collision cubes and planes and put them up around the side of your house and everything. However, what will happen is if, say, a deer comes running down this area right here and you're standing over here, the deer's going to take off the other direction back to the house that's following that nav mesh, and it's just going to get stuck right here, and it'll be like running into the wall like an idiot because it thinks there's nav mesh there. The collision cube will keep it. So we're going to fix that. All that. So the first thing you have to do is make sure that your nav mesh is on the ground, basically. So you want to go ahead and go over here, and we're going to take and highlight this one and hold control, highlight this one, keep control held, and highlight this one, then push F. Well, it didn't want to do it. So we're going to use the Z key, and we're going to move those down to where they're just above the ground like that, and then try to do it for each one individually. This is very strenuous, detailed work kind of thing. I've said many, many times that nav mesh is a complete pig to do. So you go around and you just kind of make sure it's dropped to the ground. You don't have to, but I'm just kind of OCD about things. So see where some of them, especially if you've leveled the ground out any and changed the level of the ground, you want to go ahead and make sure these are dropped to the ground. Don't worry about like right here and everything. We'll do all that. So that's pretty good. Now this is the only proper way to do this is to do the nav mesh like I'm about to show you. So you have to make sure that you're on your nav mesh tool here. You have to make sure that the select edges is turned on. I usually turn off the vertices and usually the faces, so that way I'm just selecting the edges. So I'm going to start at the stairs right here, and I want to get in close here, and when you hover your cursor over it, it'll turn bright, and then you right click one time and that will put a vertice in. So we're going to go ahead and turn our vertices back on so that we can move this. And I usually put it a little bit off to the side of the stairs and F to drop it to the ground. Still not all the way down. Z to right there. Now I can take this vertice, and if it's not selecting your edge, just move it around, see where it selects it, like that. Now I don't really want that one to be right there. So same thing. I'm going to move this one over to here. And F to drop it to the ground. And surprisingly enough, that one drops straight down. So we'll go ahead and kind of center it up there. So those are good. Now I want some more vertices here. So I'm going to go ahead and play with this. Get one of them in there at least. This is sometimes very touchy. So we're going to do that. We're going to do that. Now, I got three vertices. I don't need that many. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to push. Highlight these, and then I'm going to push the Q button, and that will bring it in, drop it to the ground, just like that. Now, you haven't really done anything yet, so go ahead, while in the vertice mode, while in the nav mesh mode, go ahead and save your mod. So, this is good practice right here. What we're going to do is we're going to open up our Skyrim data folder. I have a folder in my data folder right here. It's called ESP Backups right here. So I'm going to open that, and I'm going to make a new folder, and I'm going to call this Housing Tutorial. I'm going to make a new folder in there. And then I'm going to go ahead and find my plugin that I'm working on in my data folder, which is my tutorial rack cell right here. I'm going to copy a plugin, and I'm going to back that up in this folder. That way, if I make any mistakes in the nav meshing, I can come back to this point. So that's a good thing. Now go ahead and turn your nav mesh back on, and you can see I have this right here. And basically what you're wanting to do, we're going to go ahead and move that up and Control Z because I screwed up. We're going to go ahead and move that up because we want to move this over. Basically, what you want to do is you want to cut out all the way around the house. So we're going to get over here. And sometimes it messes around. And if it does that, try saving where it doesn't choose the proper edge. It doesn't like to, sometimes it doesn't like to choose the edge. And if it does this, sometimes it's best to, where it's not choosing the edge, sometimes it's best just to reload your kit. Like I just did, I reloaded my kit, had to reload my kit, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a vertice in there, and I'm going to put one in here, and I'm going to look at this. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to choose this one and hold control, choose this one, push the Q button, and I'm going to slide this one over all the way to the corner here and drop it to the ground. And then you want to go and cut out the hole around the whole house. So I'm going to go ahead and do that here. Now there might be two. We're going to go ahead and push F. That's fine. And it'll automatically put a line in right there. And I'm going to... You don't have to join these, but sometimes it makes it easier when there's only one vertice there so that you can pick this stuff. Like this here. And then I can take and do this. I'm going to pick this one, and then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to highlight these. Push Q. Bring those over. I see a lot of stuff here. So we're going to go ahead and push Q on these. And you'll see right here, when you turn on your thing here, there is a, somewhere there's a nav mesh overlapping because it has like a different color. When you're looking down at it, it'll be like a different color red. That's okay, because we're gonna take all of those out of there. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep going around the house. Like this. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna join all these up into one. So that's one big piece of nav mesh there. And same thing here. I have one right here. I'm gonna move out. So I'm gonna go ahead and join these two. That will be fine. And if there's not any nav mesh like that, you can go ahead and add nav mesh in. But this, since this is underneath, that will be fine. But you can add your nav mesh in here by selecting, just like in the house, selecting three vertices. Sometimes you need to think about putting an extra vertice in like that so that you can go ahead and add a vertice, push F, and push A to fill it. And then we'll take and push A there. And if you see your borders, you don't want to mess with your borders unless you absolutely know what you're doing. So I do want to go ahead and add, and these were where those trees were at. So I want to go ahead and I want to add nav mesh here like that. So I got that. I'm going to take it. I'm going to finalize it. And it doesn't take very long usually. So that's pretty good right there. And I want to take this one here and move this out. I can use this hole here, but there's awfully large piece that isn't nav meshed, and it is along the border. So I want to be able to, I want to fill all of this in. Now the problem is that there's nothing over here, because there was a tree here, if you guys remember correctly, and there is like a little ramp up there. So what I'm going to do is, since this is up here like this, I'm going to take and I'm going to highlight on the border here, on this side of that border, I'm going to highlight that one, and I'm going to highlight that one, and I'm going to add one in right there. And then I'm going to highlight just that one. And I'm going to move it over till it stops moving and it starts moving in a different direction. And go over to the side of the border right here. I'm going to choose one, drop one. And the one I dropped, push Control Z. Just want to highlight that one. The one I dropped, I'm going to move that over to there. Try to get it underneath of it. Pretty close. Now, if you're like I am, you're OCD about stuff floating in the air, just drop it to the turf. And push F. And then I want to fill this in here. So this is all filled in. Remember, highlight them like this. And push A. And the smaller the rectangle, the smaller the triangle is out here, you can go ahead, is probably better because it the NPCs like the smaller triangles when outside for whatever reason. Now I'm gonna go ahead and fill this all in right here. Now because there is a path for NPCs to get up there. So I'm going to fill it all in. And that is filled in. Now, if you need to move this vertice back, that's fine. But just remember to move it up underneath that one. So when you finalize your nav mesh, it all finalizes correctly. So what we're basically going to do is just go ahead and fill this all in with nav mesh in this cell. If they're together like that, take and pull them apart so that you can finish the nav mesh here. And it makes it easier when you want to fill in the rest of it. This. Just like that. And I need to be in the cell, I do believe. Yes. And I'll go ahead and complete that. And I'm going to have to find that one right there, so I need to turn that on. You can see that's underneath of that. That doesn't need to be there. So we're going to go ahead and join those two. Just like before. Turn the on top view back on, and we're going to finish that up. And then this last one, we're going to finish this one up. Now we need to put our border back together. So this here is all the way up to the edge. This one needs to come all the way up to the edge. Same thing with these ones. Make sure they're all the way up to the edge. I like to drop them just to make sure. Make sure they're together. I like to have them right up, make sure they're right up on the edge, because that's kind of important. And then we're going to take this one, drop it to the ground, take this one there, drop that one to the ground. And that's good. Now, on this side of the nav mesh border here, you want to push your finalize button, and this will take a little bit, and you'll see that the border has changed. Now you want to go into the next cell and push your finalize button. So that's good. Now we'll continue with, now that we've got that border fixed, we will continue on around the house. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of pull this nav mesh back here and kind of adjust the vertices so where it's easy to cut out. Now, if there's lots of vertices like this, like I said, go ahead and join those up. And we'll join that one. Oh, we'll join this one here. And join this one here. And that will give me a easier way to cut. Now I see there's a missing piece of nav mesh right there. See where that's at? See that space right there? There's a missing piece of nav mesh. So we need to find out what's going on there. Those two aren't joined. That's giving you your space, so go ahead and join them because it'll make it easier. And we'll move back here, see what we're working with. And you can see that it's on the border, so we can go ahead and got a little bit of nav mesh there. Take a look at in see-through mode. And we will add a piece. We'll add some nav mesh right there. This is basically just for the NPCs so they don't start complaining. And this is on the border too, so we're gonna move this back and we're gonna fill this one in right here. And then we'll do this part right here. And the same thing over here. Fill this all in. And then fill this one in right here. We will make sure our border's back up to there. Push F, drop it. Make sure our border's nice and hard up against the other one. Push F to drop it and finalize. And that will give you that right there. That's good. And finalize on the other side. That's good. Now, we don't have to. We're going to want to go ahead and put another vertice in right here. And I'm going to put my nav mesh back up on the top. And this one here, I'm going to leave like that. Actually, I'm going to move this one to where it's a little bit closer to the house. And this will do the whole front of the house just like this. And that's good. All right. Go ahead and get back in your cell and finalize and save. Now, when you do that, you've got your log here, and it's gonna give you some errors, like this one right here, and that. We don't need to worry about that. That's not our cell. But when you look at it, it's going to say such and such has a link to such and such, and it won't link up. So these are giving you errors when you save in your cell. Now, what you're going to have to do when we do after we cut them, then we'll have to find our errors. So go ahead and save your close your nav mesh and save your mod. And the next part here, we'll go into the actual cutting. Did you remember to, when you saved your mod, did you remember to back up your plugin? I did. So yeah, if you haven't done it yet, go ahead and back your plugin up right now. So I'm going to turn my nav mesh back on. Now this is the kind of tricky part. You want to take and you want to have your, you can turn that off and turn the edges off, because you just want to highlight the actual whatever they're called, triangles. Yeah, you just want to highlight the triangles underneath the house. And what I do is I go and I'm just gonna highlight all the ones. Oh, see, now that's a problem. You see the problem here? It highlighted that, so I'm going to have to start over with that, and I'm going to have to select this edge, and I'm going to have to put a vertice in right there, so this only selects that. And if I had already did all the rest of the house and came to that part, I would have been a little bit angry, because then you have to select these all again. Yeah, when you select it once, hold control and then select everything. Make sure your edges are turned off, because that can be kind of a hassle. So we're gonna go around and select all of these parts on the edges, just like this. Now when I get to this part, I'm not really certain that it will. Make sure you've got all of these. You can go inside of your house here, and you can do it from underneath as well. But if you're close to the water like I am, here's the problem. You can always turn your water off as well. There's a way to turn your water off. Oh, I don't want to select world space. Tape. Shift W. Anyway, I think that turns off all the while. Shift W. Yeah, that's. You could turn the water off with Shift W. I didn't know that was down there. What is that? Is that a dragon mound down there? Okay. Alrighty then. Oh, yeah, anyway, little tangent, you can go ahead and keep selecting all of your red nav mesh underneath the house. And if you need to do mount, that's fine too. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select all this like this. Make sure you get it all. And that looks like it's pretty much all of it. Yes, sir. Take a look around outside. It looks like it's all of it. Make sure you're in the cell. Go over here. And what you want to do is up here on the toolbar, you see nav mesh. And you go ahead and you click on that and select move selection to a separate nav mesh. When you do that, then you go ahead and hit your finalize nav meshes. And it will give you the blue lines around here. So when you click in here and you push F, when you click in here and you push the fill button, the flood fill, it will flood fill everything that you selected. See how it's doing that? And you go ahead and you want to go ahead and push delete right now, just like that. And that is a separate nav mesh. You see that? You want to go ahead and choose that, move that to a separate nav mesh and finalize it. And then delete it. And go ahead right now and push your save button. It'll take a few minutes and it will cut your house out just like that. Now you want to go ahead and push your cover button, this button with the question mark, find cover edges. And it has all the cover, it puts in all the cover edges and it's good. Save your mod right now. Take a look at your log right here. Now it says there's some links that need to be fixed. So it will take and fix these links right now. So what do we got here? Master file nav mesh cell in the farm. The nav mesh is right here. So you want to highlight it and push control, hold control and C. And you want to find the do the control F on this bar here and open this up and nav mesh ID, paste that in there. And we want to go to, and this is not anything that I did. This is in the game. So I'm not going to worry about it. It's in my cell, but I'm not really going to worry about it. So yeah, see, a lot of these are not even in my, in what I did. This is vanilla errors. So same thing here. We want to check to see if any of these errors are in my mod where I put them in there. So we're gonna, and it didn't even move, so there's nothing wrong with that one. We'll try with this first one right here. So hold control, see, and then we'll paste this in right here. Push the go to button. And it doesn't want to do that. But everything should work right here. If there's some errors, it's probably in the vanilla errors. If you did this correctly, it's probably in some vanilla errors. I see a problem here. I forgot to choose a couple of these. So I'm going to go ahead and choose these, and I'm going to move that selection to a separate nav mesh. I'm going to go ahead and finalize it, and then I'm going to choose those again. I'm going to delete it, and finalize it again and save the mod. And then maybe move this one. Oh, I gotta turn my vertices back on so I can select them. That, and then do my cover button. And I might want to actually drop that one to the ground. Some of these you might want to drop to the ground. Just say. Okay, that part is done. This part is done. So now we need to nav mesh our porches, and then we'll move on. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and finalize this. Now, when you're doing your porch, don't do this part down here first. There's a rule. Same rule applies in exterior nav meshing, top down. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go here and try to do it to where it's going to be over top of the empty space you just created. Because if you do it wrong, you go like that. See how it won't add it, but then when you go like this, it will. When you tilt it a little bit, because it's underneath, there's no nav mesh underneath it. Remember what I said about dropping it to the ground? Oh, it's a bad idea. Yeah. Now I just want to go ahead and link up put all my nav mesh in on this second floor. Sometimes it's tricky. You gotta make sometimes you have to be right on top of it. You have to tilt it and play with it a little bit just to make sure that it's you're doing it over the empty spots. And we'll go ahead and fill that. And when you get to the edges of it, sometimes it's tricky because sometimes you have to do this and then drag it across like that. So basically what I'm doing here is now I'm going to fill this in and I'm going to make sure I got all my markers. I'm going to make sure all of my markers are on the nav mesh. Like this here crafting mark, this panning rack. That's good. Now I can do my stairs down here. It'd be much easier for the stairs. Easy, just I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do the stairs up like this, and I'm going to go ahead and put this over here like that, and that's good. So I'm going to hit my fine cover edges and finalize it and save it. And that's good. I can close that and save that. Now, what I'm going to do, that's just this video. I know it's been long. That's to teach you how to do the exterior nav meshing. I'm going to have to do that with my blacksmith, my smithing house over here. And on the next video, I will show you how to link your interior cell to your exterior cell. All right, guys, that's going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Remember, if you found this information helpful, to smash that like button. And when you do that, make sure that you share it to your social media. When you share it to your social media, follow me on that Frog app. The link is in the description. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done yet already, and hit that notification bell for all. And if you've got any questions or comments, leave them down below the video and I'll get back to you as I read all my comments. Those are all the free and easy things you can do to help support channel. If you want to support channel directly, look down in the description. Use the Ko-fi link for a one-time tip or to become a channel member. All right, guys, that's going to do it for this one. Thanks for watching. And remember, until next time, keep your sword sharp, don't be a milk drinker, and always watch the skies, traveler.